Good evening and welcome to my latest review. Tonight I thought I'd cover one of my older Hornby Class 6s that I've owned since 2006. And this is the Rail Express Limited Edition of 60081 in the GWR Brunswick Green livery. As some of you may have realised by now that I am a fan of the GWR railways and also the GWR themed locomotives as well. And this one is no exception, as this is 6081 and is named as Isambard Kingdom Brunel. Hope I've pronounced that correctly. And when I bought the model new in 2006, It did come with etched nameplates and etched number plates, which would be fitted here and here. And the model was around nearly £100, I think, when I bought it new. But these now go for well over that on eBay. And because it's a limited edition, you will only be able to buy these pre-owned now. Anyways, moving on. Let's open the box. Let's have a look at the model in the flesh. You do get a ton of goodies with these Class 60s, and I do like the detail. The model is DCC ready, and it does use the 8-pin DCC decoders. But something that you don't get with the Hornby Class 60s that are in common production is the certificate. I will come on to the instructions in a moment, but let's have a look at the certificate. Once we've unfolded it, you will get a certificate like this, or you should do, with your version of the Hornby Class 60 if you are seeking a model of 6081 yourself. And here is all the information, including a picture of the actual locomotive, which did attend the Old Oak Common train show in 2000, which is just over 10 years ago. The certificate of this locomotive is 132 of 1200 pieces produced worldwide, and complete with the Hornby logo on the left there. So, that's the certificate covered. I'll just fold this up, so I'll be with you in a moment. But anyways, that's the certificate all folded up. Here is the next amount of paperwork, which is the instructions. Complete with the reference number of R2604 and the year of issue, which is 2006. So, upon opening the instructions, it tells you how to fit the optional chain link coupler, which is non-working, so it's a dummy detail part, by the way. And also a diagram of how to switch over the air dams to the full air dam from that with a cutout for the coupler. And also there's some diagrams on how to remove the body if you wish to fit a DCC socket, correction, a DCC decoder. And also some more information on how to lubricate the moving parts. Whoops. Complete with a selector switch underneath the fuel tank for night and day operations. Complete with some more areas of where lubricating oil can be applied. So, very informative. That's the paperwork taken care of. You do get, yet again, a DCC decoder insulating jacket, but as I've said on just about every review of a Hornby model that's DCC ready, these are kind of obsolete and they're only really useful to have if you have the older non-insulated decoders. So that can be just be popped on top of the sleeve and the paperwork out of the way. Right, that leaves us one major component to review and to unpack, and that's the model itself, from the styrene tray and the plastic clips that holds the front piece on. But before we do that, I'm going to lower the camera for you to give you a better position. And also, you may have noticed I've left the coupler loose on top of the box, as it's easier to install onto the model quicker rather than putting it in the bag and taking it out of the bag, as it was originally in the bag. So I've done this for quick access for when I decide to run the model. Right, enough talk. I think it's time to set up the test track and also take the model out of the styrene tray. I will apologise in advance if there is any creaking of the styrene, as I do tend to find the noise of polystyrene quite irritating. Although it may not bother some of you, but I do apologise to those of you in advance that it might. So, upon removing the styrene tray and the front screen, we now have the tissue wrap, and we now unveil the excellent replica of the Hornby Class 60, which is 6081. Just carefully lifting it out of the styrene tray and away from the two retaining plastic brackets. Just place that out of the way. I will now place the model onto the test track and I will give you all some close-ups. Now, the first thing you will notice on the model is the gold coloured air horns, just like with the prototype, and the yellow warning panel coloured headlight clusters. Not many Hornby Class 60s, apart from my customised 60008 that I own, have these. And also, you've got the etched number plate on the side. This has been added by myself, along with the nameplate. As to avoid damaging the model, I tend to use water-based glues. Well, I did when I first started applying nameplates to models, as I don't want to ruin the paintwork. But anyways, let's zoom in and let's have a close-up of 6081 from cab number one. Just like with every Hornby Class 60 that I've reviewed, you do get sprung buffers. This one's a little bit more loose than this one, but this one's quite stiff. You get head and tail lights, and you also get opening doors. You've also got the separately etched fitted handrails, and you've got flush glazing throughout, complete with etched window wipers, an etched handrail across the front, and also directional lighting. So, if I just zoom out, let's have a look at the roof. You've also got etched fitted fan grills, although the fans are not visible on the Hornby Class 60, just like with a prototype. If we just pan the camera across the top of the model, you will also see where I have added the Isambard Kingdom Brunel nameplates on the side, and also the silver coloured exhaust pod. If we just zoom in towards the cab number two, you will also notice that there is some more etched horns. Currently on 8x zoom, I have to be very gentle with the zoom so we avoid blurring. If I just pan the camera down, you can also see the extra grille on the right hand side. If I just zoom back into 6x zoom, do beg your pardon. And you've also got the gold printed EWS beastie just below the driver's cab window from the rear view. Right, I think that's covered all the close-ups. It's time to do the most important thing in the review, and that's the test drive. I'll just position my test track so it's completely on the desk and it's not overhanging. And the controller I shall use for this test drive is your typical Hornby R965 train controller. As we've got some space to move forwards, I shall move forwards first, and then I shall reverse to make full use of the test track. Oops, it seems that the headlights are not working on the front, so I'll just fix that and I'll be back in a moment. Welcome back, and apologies for that. The problem was due to a poor contact between the chassis and the headlight boxes, but I've now remedied the problem and it all now works. So, as there is a bit of track in front from where the camera is, I shall move forward and then I shall reverse. As you can see, the headlights are very nice and bright, so that makes operating the Hornby Class 60 at night quite interesting and enjoyable. For some reason, the driveline does squeak a little when going in reverse, but that could be that it may need a full run-in when going in reverse as well as forwards. But when going forwards, it is relatively quiet. And as you can see there, the acceleration and the continuous running on this Hornby Class 60 is very smooth. And I will confess that the Hornby Class 60 is probably one of the best models that Hornby have made up to yet so far. And for those that have a modern image layout, I would certainly recommend a Hornby Class 60 if you do not already own one. And there is a choice of those with DCC sound and those that are DCC ready, just like this one. So, that concludes the review of this Hornby Class 60 in the special commissioned EWS and GWR livery, which is 6081 and is named as Isambard Kingdom Brunel. My final score for this excellent model, I'm going to give it a perfect 10 out of 10. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below. And thank you for watching. Stay tuned for another video coming soon. And have a good week. Thank you.